It is a joy for me to stand here to represent Trappings and bidding you farewell. Yet, we are just giving our appreciation for the things that you have done for us. It was about 3 years ago, God sent Pastor to us. And he came with a lot of speed, knowing that he maybe have a short time. He was there with us, walking hard while we trying to get God's house to somewhere where it should, you know, represent God. And he was always there with us, walking hard. And Pastor, we just want to thank you. We know that it wasn't easy for you, but you just give it all because you know that you are doing it for the Lord. And when you walk for God, we know that God is a God. He changed not. He stick to his promises, and God always promised to take care of his own. So on behalf of Trappings, we just want to thank you for your dedication and for your hard work. And in the same tone of voice, we want to say farewell. It is not an easy thing for us to say, but we realize that the time has come that you have to leave. And God has called you to a higher level. And with all this in mind, we just want to thank you for all the things that you have done for us. So on behalf of the elders, the officers, and the members of the Trappings Seventh-day Adventist Church, we just want to say thank you. And we will continue to send up prayers for you. And we know that God answers prayer. And we know, according to his words, that he's going to continue to bless you. So for one and all, I say thank you.
I just want to say thank you, and may God continue to bless both of you. This is a little token of our appreciation.
Okay, good morning, everyone. I really am standing at this time with mixed feeling, you know, because just at the time when we at Trappings were getting to really know Pastor McDonald and getting into him and his family, that's the time he's been snatched away from us to go to a different district. But we have been impressed, Pastor McDonald. And your family, we have been impressed that you love the Lord, that you love the work, and we are impressed as well that you are interested in people, in seeing that people improve themselves and come to a knowledge of the saving grace of Christ. And so we are indeed very happy and thankful for your service. We sorry it has not been longer, but who knows, probably one of these days you may return to Choppins, all right? As long as life lasts. We thank you for your unselfish devotion. We thank you for your zeal, your enthusiasm, and we thank you for your very presence, making it your duty. I was really impressed with you on that Sunday when you did the funeral for Sister Stephanie, Sister Steph, and the other sisters in Choppins. It was Sunday, and I know it's very hard to come all the way from Leyu, but you were there. Also, we had our business meeting just in the week gone, coming all the way from Leyu in the night, and you were there. So we thank you very much. We didn't take those things for granted. It's only someone who loves, cares, and appreciates the brethren who goes out of his way to get his work done. So as you leave, we pray that the Lord would be with you and your family. You would be blessed. We thank you for the blessings that we have received as a result of your being with us, your ministry. Thank you, Brother Glasgow, for that lovely word. We wish you all the best, and we hope that the Lord would bless you, take care of you, and we hope that the same love that Southern District, and even greater love that Southern District demonstrated to you, you will receive as you go into your new district. May God bless you and keep you. And may he bless your ministry. And may your work be fruitful. And one of these days, I'm sure, if we all keep faithful to the end, when Jesus comes, we will all be in that number. Amen. All the best. Thank you. And God bless you and your family.
Well, protocol already has been established. I don't want to say much. But all I can say, as a district, what can we say? God loves you, and so do we.
Amen. Without any further ado, we call on the Glen brethren. It's now the turn of Glen. Glen, where are you? Going once, going twice, Glen.
Good morning, brethren. It is so good to stand here today. But I am standing in appreciation of our pastors, but in particular, Pastor Brent St. Jean and Sister St. Jean. I met Pastor St. Jean in 2003, I think. He wasn't yet a pastor. But from that day that I met Pastor St. Jean, I knew that the Lord would do great things for him. I remember saying to him one time, Pastor, well, he wasn't pastor then. I said, one of these days, you are going to be the conference evangelist. I told him that. Before he went to school. because listening to him, spending time around him, I knew that God was going to do great things in his life. And I am proud to stand here this morning on behalf of the brethren from Glen, Pastor St. Jean and Sister St. Jean. We really appreciate your hard work. We know that God has used you mightily. We know that as you have moved on, that he will continue to work for you. He will continue to use you. We are not losing you because you're just a phone call away. But we want to encourage you to continue to be Pastor and Sister St. Jean. Because sometimes, you know, as we move up, things get in our way. I don't think things will get in your way. I think you will continue to be who you are. Pastor St. Jean is one that the young people can relate to. He knows how to get down to the young people. He's one who will listen to the youths. Because of his dynamism, the young people would gravitate towards him. So I want to wish you and Sister St. Jean all the best. God's richest blessings on you both. And continue, we will continue to pray for you as we know you will pray for us. So may God bless you as you go. I call on Darian to present first to Sister St. Jean.
Amen, amen, amen. Much love, much love. Good morning, church. I stand with Zariel Quintin and Darian James, my assistants this morning, as we recognize and acknowledge the time the pastoral family, Pastor Keith McDonald, Sister Sonia McDonald, and little Caris. We thank them for the short time they spent at Glen. From January 2016, we were planning a crusade at Glen from the Southern District. And it was planned, and then we heard this young man, vibrant, energetic, who will be coming. And of course, we all know the crusade keep putting back because we hear he was in another crusade. And then he arrived, and he did not disappoint us. Amen, church? Yes, let's put our hands together. This is a beautiful family. Easy to get along with, to work with. He laughs and always has a ready smile, and Sister McDonald laughs, LOL, you know the LOL? Laugh out loud. Yes, but a beautiful family, and Caris always questioning. But we were happy to get to know you for the short time, and we know that as you go on, we're not really sad about it. We're happy because we know that God is going to move you again and continue to increase you. And you will not disappoint. He has promised a reward for those of us who plant. You know, so we are happy for that. And we wish you Godspeed. At this time, we're going to ask Zariel, who's going to give Sister McDonald her bouquet. Amen. Let's give them a round of applause. And Darian is going to give Pastor McDonald his plaque. Uh-huh. Okay. Amen. Amen. Okay, Glen Church, wherever Glen Church is represented, just stand. Just stand wherever Glen Church is represented. Pastor and Sister McDonald, you have become family. So not because you're now in that other district. You can still call on us. You can still make a call. You can still visit. You know, right, Glenn? Yeah. Right? So let us wave our hands, showing that we're not only bidding you farewell, but we're bidding you success and Godspeed.
Let's give them another round of applause. Just reminding those who would be making their presentation to come that we have an official photographer in the house. We need the pictures. So please pose so that the camera lady can have that photograph. Yes. And now we will have a special in song as we serenade our pastors. Coming from Choppins, Sister Donna Dryan.
A special good morning to everyone. To God be the glory, great things he has done. In Psalms 92 and verse 1, it says, it is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises unto his holy name. You deserve the glory and the honor as we lift our hands to worship and praise your holy name. You deserve the glory and the honor as we lift our hands to worship and praise your holy name. 'Cause you are great, you're the miraculous, so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. You deserve the glory, Jesus, and the honor. As we lift our hands to worship and praise your holy name, you deserve the glory and the honor. As we lift our hands to worship and praise your holy name, 'cause you are great, you're the miraculous, so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. 'Cause you are great, you're the miraculous, so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you.
Praise the Lord. He's great. What a lovely song. As I looked around, I just want to welcome to our pastor's appreciation and farewell service a man of God who has been in this district for some time, Pastor Steve Phillips. The man is in the house. We are happy to have you, Pastor. Time is slipping by. I just want to inform you so that you can get your minds tuned in. There will be a baptism today during the service. You see, the men came in with a blaze of glory and they are going out with a blaze of glory, baptizing people in the Southern District. What a good way to go out. Okay, without any further ado, as we express our love we call on Stubbs. Stubbs in the house, it's your turn.
I must say a pleasant Sabbath to everyone. Good morning, we are in the best place and at the right time. In God's house, there are blessings forevermore. To our pastors, our God has sent you to this place to lead us in the way that he would have us walk and think and live from day to day. No matter the hour, whatever the need, you go the extra mile, always ready and willing to share a comforting thought and a smile. We are grateful that you're here with us to teach us from his word, and we will try to do our best in service of our Lord. We thank you for your ministry, your guidance, and your care. His greatest blessings for your lives is our most humble prayer. On behalf of our church in Stubbs, the elders and the members of the Stubbs Seventh Adventist Church, we truly appreciate all that the two pastors have been doing for us and their families. They have been very supportive to us in one way or the other. They don't take God's work slightly. They take it very seriously. And I know with these two pastors, there will be a bright future for the youths and more so to our adults. So Pastor Brent St. Jean and your wife, Pastor Keith McDonald and your wife and your daughter, we just want to say thanks for your support, your leading, your encouragement, your dedication towards us. And as you move on with your life to a higher plane, that God would continue to bless you all in your ministry, and that Jesus will be seen in all of your lives, and you will continue to lead souls to the foot of the cross. Thank you very much.
To Pastor Keith McDonald, we support and appreciate all of the things you have done for us, faithful preaching and teaching of God's word. You have one of the toughest jobs today. You are overworked, often taken for granted, often criticized. You're even burdened with issues and tasks besides preaching, and yet having an example of a victorious Christian. On behalf of the Stubbs SDA Church, we present to you this food basket because we believe that your health, a healthy man is a wealthy man. So we wish you all the best in your new district, and may God continue to bless you and your family.
And one thing I must say, pastors, we will not forget you at any time at all.
Yes, as today we praise God for our pastors who served us throughout the years. They laughed with us during our humor and comforted us during our tears. We are happy for you, our beloved pastors. And now we call upon the home church, Monk Moriah, as they share their love with our pastors.
Indeed, we in the Southern District have been truly blessed to have had two pastors with us. At the beginning of 2013, Pastor Brent St. Jean joined this district. And he was wondering if he was going to remain here for the full 4 years, because according to him, he had never had the opportunity to be in a district for 4 years. And thank be to God Almighty, he was kept here for 4 years. And in September of 2016, we were joined by Pastor McDonald and his wife, Sister McDonald, and a child. And we were truly blessed from the crusade. He was brought here to the Southern District so that he could have the crusade that was conducted at Glen. And I'm telling you, he came and he blended well with the brethren of the Southern District. So I want to start first with Pastor McDonald. I know he came in after Pastor Brent, but we'll start with him first. And Pastor McDonald, we are truly happy, blessed, delighted for you and your family that you came to this district to preach the gospel. I've found Pastor McDonald to be a humble person. He has a quiet personality. He is really a man of God, sticks to his word. And we were truly and are truly blessed that he brought with him those strengths and he was able to deliver the word night after night at the crusade and even also in the church. And we want to thank you very much for the work, for your ministry. And we encourage you to continue to preach the gospel, preach it without compromising, preaching if those don't love it, continue to preach it, and God will bless you indeed. We want to thank him and thank Almighty God for promoting him from being an assistant pastor to being a pastor. Pastor of the Central District he will be. And we want to continue to keep him in our prayers. It doesn't matter where he may be, that God will bless and keep him along with his family. So Pastor, thank you for the work, for your ministry that you have done in the Southern District. And may God continue to richly bless you. And as a sign of our appreciation from Mount Moriah Seventh-day Adventist Church, we just like to present to both of you, to the entire family, Pastor McDonald and Sister McDonald and his child, these tokens of appreciation. Turn for the camera. Let's turn for the camera. So we can get the faces. Let's put our hands, yes, we could. Pastor McDonald. We love him so much that we decided to give him two gifts. I think the elder would like us to see how what we are. Just turn that the camera could pick it up also. Praise the Lord, quite lovely. So small things, good things come in small bags, but we won't open that bag. We'll keep it sealed. Let's call on our dear Sister Jack to present the gift to Sister McDonald. Oh, Karish. Brother James. We have a fruit basket. Just smile for the camera, Sister Jack. Let us put our hands together for the pastoral family. We're happy for the work, and may God continue to bless them greatly as they minister day after day to God's people and leading men and women and children to the foot of the cross. Then we turn our attention to Pastor Brent St. Jean and his loving wife. I've gotten to know Pastor Brent, as I said before, in 2013 when he joined the district. He joined at the time when we were having a district crusade at the Kaliakwa, and Brother Morris Rogers was the preacher at that time. And I've gotten to know Pastor, got very close to him, gotten to know him as a strong leader, a vibrant person, full of energy. Pastor will run up and down to the four churches in the district every Sabbath. And I will say to Pastor, just come to the church that you're going to preach and just remain there from song service all the way. No. Full of energy. Go from one church to the next church to the four churches throughout the district in one Sabbath, in one passing. And he is very eloquent. He's a good speaker. Yes, he knows the word very much. Pastor knows how to take a passage of scripture and just, you know, rip it apart, build it up, show you all sorts of angles from that same passage of scripture, whether it's acute, obtuse, whether it's the right angle or what have you. It doesn't matter. You'll be able to get it from him. Amen? Am I speaking the truth? Yes, so I've learned a lot in terms of his preaching style and so forth, and I want to thank him very much and Pastor Sister Sinja for the work, the lovely work that they have done in this district. And God has called him to a higher calling. Called him to be the youth leader and also evangelistic leader in the mission. And we would like to pray God's blessing upon both of them, that they will continue to do the work and the ministry that God has called them to do. And Pastor, continue to do a good job. Continue to, don't be afraid to rebuke and correct and reprove and instruct into righteousness. This is what God has called you to do. And so as to show appreciation to him, we would like to present to the family, to the St. John family, two tokens of appreciation. So this time, so let's put our hands together for Pastor Brent St. John. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yeah, something that he could remember, look at all the time, and the rest of his life. Just for the camera. Sister, just join in. Next one. And now we turn our attention to Sister St. Jean as we present Sister Noel does the presentation. Amen. Wonderful. Put our hands together. The pastor has turned over back to Brother Noel.
Yes, that's all the love that we have for our beloved pastors and their families. We are nearing the end of this part of the service. Just two items more for this part of the service. And I'm wondering which one I should take first. Anyhow, I will call on Monk Moriah to do that special song right now.
Life is full of challenges, and I know for pastors, it's very challenging. And it's a big shoes to fill. So pastors, I sing this song, pastors and sisters. As I sing this song, I want you to especially to listen to the words. And once you put your life in God's hands, he will take you through whatever storms you may have. Life could be so good. Life can be so hard. Never knowing what it brings to where you are. Sometimes I forget. Sometimes I can see. But whatever comes my way, you'll be there for me. My life is in your hand. My heart is in your keeping. I'm never without hope. Now when the future is with you, with your love, we'll live eternally. So I will find my rest, and I will find my peace, knowing what will come my way, you'll be there for me. My life is in your hands. In your keeping, I'm never without hope, not when my future is with you. My life is in your hands, and though I may not see clearly, I will lift my voice and sing,
Lord, you carried me, and I'll become your strongest, Lord, in your way. My life is in your hand, my heart is in your keeping. I never without hope, not when my future is with you. My life is in your hands, and though I may not see clearly, I will lift my voice and sing, 'cause your love does amazing things, Lord. Lord, I know, dear, lives are in your hands. I trust you, Lord, dear, God's hand. Their lives is in God's hand.
Yes, their lives are in God's hands. We thank you for that special song. And now, pastors, we give you the little 1 minute, 90 seconds to give your response. 90 seconds each. The mics are right there. Take the blue one.
Happy Sabbath, everybody. I think I'm a man with many words, but I'm lost for words this morning. I'm really lost for words. I am delighted. I am happy. I feel blessed. I feel love to be here this morning. As it was established before, it was a short stay. But within this short stay that we had here, it was a beautiful stay. We enjoy ourselves. We had encouragement from everybody. We had support from everybody. The whole district worked so well together and gave us so much support that we felt like we were home. Every time we enter, it doesn't matter which church, whether Stubbs, whether Choppins, whether Glen, whether Mount Moriah. Once we enter, we felt at home. And it tells me that there are mature Christians within these churches. And we really want to thank you for your love and your support and your prayers. I ask that as we leave just across the road from where you are here, that God will continue to bless you. Amen. And that God will continue to lead you into paths of righteousness. I ask that God's blessing will continually be in our hearts, in your heart, and that you will allow God to lead you. And don't stray. Don't go. Don't move. Especially those new converts. You're still a babe. You're still growing. Don't leave the church. Keep walking. There will be some hard times coming, but keep holding on Jesus. And even those members who are concrete in the church, sometimes there are some winds that come your way. You're never sure. You never know that those kind of winds will blow you away. Keep strong in Jesus. Keep holding on him. And thank you very much. And for the pastor that will come, show him the same love that you showed us. Show him just show him the same love that you show us and continue to be good Christians with Jesus. Thank you very much, everybody.
Amen. I'm asking the escorts to stand by.
Well, if you give Pastor McDonald 90 seconds, you have to give me double that. So, see. Good morning, brethren. It's a hard moment for me. It's very, very, very hard for me because I love this district so much. I mean, It's the first district that I've spent a full stint as pastor. And I came here, I came in this district at a hard time. Just came from Jamaica, and it was a discouraging time in ministry for us. I was going through a lot in terms of ministry and to find my place in ministry and whether I should have come back to St. Vincent or stay in Jamaica, because I had a very big job offer in Jamaica, and I really wondered if coming to St. Vincent was the best thing. And it was a tough decision, and coming back here, I just didn't know what to do. I didn't know how I should go about doing it as a pastor. And God just blessed. And I thank him for a supportive wife who's always been there for me and always been fighting with me and standing by my side. I thank God for that. And I thank God for good elders. When I came here, really supportive elders. I worked a long time with Elder Rogers and then Sister Andrews for a little while. And you all showed me nothing but love in Glen. And in Choppins, I worked along with Elder Tirila's first elder for the 4 years I was there. And Elder Tirila's just been a blessing to me. I mean, and the leadership of the churches, the members of the churches. And if I come to Mount Moriah, I served my 4 years there as first elder. Elder Haynes was the first elder. We had a good thing going along with the members there at Mount Moriah. And then at Stubbs, it was Elder Smith for some time, and then Sister Clark. And the members, I mean, you have loved me so much. And the reason why this is so hard is because you were not just my members. You're my very good friends. And we worked together. We cried together. We fight together. We make noise together. We disagree. And then at the end of the day, we still loved one another. And it's the first time I spent 4 years, and it was a four wonderful years. And God used these 4 years to prepare me. I mean, when I was voted to be the youth director and assistant to the president for evangelism, I didn't know if I was capable of doing it, but I knew that God was preparing me in these 4 years I was here to really for this calling. And I just ask you for your prayers. I have so many good friends. If I start calling names, that's the hard part. It's the friends that you have developed, and not just friends, the family that you have developed. I mean, going at your house, eat at your house. I mean, lime at your house. I mean, that's the kind of relationship we had. And I know I'm not going anywhere in terms of, but the relationship that I had with you in the past 4 years, I will not be unable to have it with a new pastor there. That's the reality. Because you want to give the new pastor his space. And I believe in that. But I want to thank you for your love. I thank my mother-in-law who's here, always been by my side. I mean, since I came here in St. Vincent in ministry, always there to encourage me, and my family back home, even if they are not here, they always pray for me, and I feel the love. I feel the love from them. But one of the things I will tell you, as I close it now, I'll take the time out of my sermon. It's me preaching. So I go cut whatever time I take, I go cut it in the sermon. And one of the things I tell people that moved me the most in this district, and that's what is so hard to leave this district. I'll tell you, in 2015, I remember it was Alban Williams was doing a crusade in Choppins. I think it was around that same time. When Storm Erica passed in Dominica and wreaked havoc in Dominica, and I got the bad news that my parents were heavily impacted. And the way the district rallied around us at that time, it was such a difficult time because I was here in St. Vincent. My parents were marooned on one side of the island. Helicopter had to be dropping food for them. Then I got the news that the house was terribly affected. And the churches came together and really helped out and prayed for us and assisted financially. And a group of guys and from here in St. Vincent, in the district. And I will call their names too, because I don't take things for granted. My parents always taught me, thank people. Don't take people for granted, because they don't have to do what they do. I want to thank Elder Davis, Jerome Davis, and Nicholas Thomas, and Cupid, Ezekiel Cupid, or Hezekiah Cupid, whatever you want to call him, and Norman Top, and who else am I missing? Am I missing anybody else, Davis? Yes, I mean, these guys came together, and they went to Dominica with me, and they worked night and day to get my parents a roof over their head. And not just that, not just that, not, Not just that. Even now, I'm not going to be the pastor in the future. These guys have already committed to go back with me at the Easter time to finish what they started. And that means so much, because you don't find members doing that for a pastor. You know, they pray for you. But they will not leave their families and leave their homes and the comfort of their homes to go and lie down on the floor and lie down on couch for 3 weeks just to put a roof over your head. And it means so much to me. And the brethren, thank you so much for your prayers. I will never forget this district. And I can say it without fear and without doubt and without mortar in my mouth. This is the best district that we've ever had the opportunity to pastor. Really, we spend the longest time there, and it's been a blessing. And now I'm back onto my normal self again. I am delighted to say that it is the last time a pastor will pastor this district in this configuration. Because after this week coming here, Shoppings will be going elsewhere, Glenn will be going elsewhere, Montmore and Stubbs will be going elsewhere. So we can say, Pastor McDonald, we were the last set. Last set of pastors to pastor this district under this current configuration. So Glenn, we wish you Godspeed, and Choppins, we wish you Godspeed as well. I mean, as Stubbs and McMoriah joins with Calder to be the new Eastern District, Glenn goes to the Southern District, and Choppins goes to the Maracor West District. A lot of separation, but keep the love going, and I want to thank Pastor McDonald for the time that we spend together as well. Pastor McDonald has become a very good friend, and his family. We are very close. In the time that we work together, we had a good working relationship. I mean, very close. We talk foolishness, and we talk serious thing, and we drive, and we even the drives going down to Kittles. It wasn't hard, because you laugh and talk all your way down, and so on. And we really had a wonderful time. So Pastor McDonald, Sister McDonald, and Caris, it was a delight working along with you for the past few months. And brethren, let's work to see the face of Jesus. That's what we are here for. And as we get ready for a new pastor, new pastors in this case, love them more than you loved us. Work harder than you ever worked with us. Because at the end of the day, it's not about the pastor who pastors the church. It's about the mission of the Lord. And let's work together. Let's work with each other. And I pray that when the Lord comes, he will say to us, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Thank you. God bless you, and it was a privilege being your pastor.
Yes, give our pastors a round of applause. As the escorts come first to take the wives. Followed by the gentlemen, take the pastors. And as we get ready for the announcements, we are asking the platform personnel to get themselves organized one time.